My name is Even Rygg. I'm from Norway, and my job is to cut ice, make an instrument out of ice, getting ice from a frozen lake, take it up, hear if there is some sound in the ice, and then try to make an instrument out of it. To find the very best sound of the ice, I need to check the ice and how the structure in the ice is, how it's built up, and then try to make as nice cut through that as possible. I often search a lot of lakes in the summer to see how the movement in the water is, and then decide if I want to try to take up some ice there in the winter. And then I'll see if the movement in the water is correct, then the sound is very good. It's when you like touch the ice, it's not just dung, it's like ding. So getting the ice from the van and into the stage, it's often a very difficult job because like the table that he was playing on, it weighs somewhere between 150 and 200 kilos. So that's a very heavy load. And also this high pillar, to get that standing straight is also often very difficult. So, the quality of the water is of course a important thing. Spring water is actually too clean. So when you freeze like spring water, it don't have the right sound. It needs to be 100% natural water. Learning how to deal with ice is just learning by doing, many mistakes and some good moments that we find out, okay, this worked, let's try to do this. The concert yesterday was the warmest concert for us ever, so 30 plus degrees is it's a new record on that side of the scale of degrees. Yeah. Our instruments are just borrowed from the nature, so for me to see that our instruments are melting is actually not, it don't hurt as much as it maybe should, because we think that we borrow it from the nature. Every instrument's melting, go out to the lake, becomes a water, it's like, yeah. So it became a part of the nature again. And we were just lucky to borrow it for a concert. So it's actually quite nice to see that it goes back to the nature again.